I think of the river the way it reads in the Sam Shepard story, Cruisin' Paradise, a huge concrete serpent, a dumping ground for murder victims. I think of the river beside a freeway off-ramp as rollerbladers bent into its spandexed buttocks rotating, roll downstream. Tender-butted mammals, skateboarders in baggy baggies and extra-large tees, 360 into the face of General Ulysses S. Grant. Even as a statue, you can tell he was a hard drinker. Mean as a culvert full of street water after the first rains. After the endless supplications to the senator, the rows of accordion files are there to remind me that after everything changes, everything remains the same, so why can't I be just a little less impatient? The American flags whip me like photo ops in the spring bluster. Buster. I think of William Mulholland's gentle limpid stream coursing from a pharaoh's forehead, or from the brow of a Rhine maiden, green-eyed and coffee-colored, a bracelet of drowned children wrapped around her wrist, descending from the mountains east of Irwindale into the Jardin des Rocas. The American flags whip me like photo ops in the spring bluster. I study the faces of lovers for a clue to something I can take back with me to my hotel. Don't be shy, guy. The hooker coos from the statue of Edmund Burke, who wrote that the tree of liberty is watered with patriotic blood. That I don't feel shy. I feel poisoned, scourged, the citizen of a penal colony. I set out to be a hero and a legend, and I ended up a lobbyist. The river is a rigorous mistress, but when you tickle her with your deeds, you can hear her laughter from beneath her concrete corset.